Today we will discuss about DC TACO generator. It is an electrical tachometer. Tachometer means, we know already, we have discussed mechanical tachometers. So it is measuring the speed of the automobile vehicle, speed of the engine, and the speed of the machine part like that. So this generator, here we are in the name, it is TACO. TACO means it is a tachometer. Generator means this generator is finding the speed. Okay, and the DC means here we are getting the output voltage is DC. That's why by seeing this voltage we can find the speed of the speed in RPM, revolution per minute. That's why we are calling DC TACO generator. Let us discuss about it. What is the basic principle of this DC TACO generator? Initially I will tell what is the generator, where we are installing the generators. We are installing the generators in big apartments and shopping malls and theaters like that. So what the generators are doing, they are supplying the electricity. Okay, so here the basic principle is generator is producing, output is electricity. Okay, so mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. Okay, in the generator output is electrical energy and input is mechanical energy. Here this generator is giving the speed. So let us see the basic principle in it. At the output voltage has developed, DC voltage. This voltage is proportional to speed of the vehicle. Here V is proportional to speed of the shaft, okay, rotational speed of the shaft. So here if V is getting more means the speed is also more. We can see it is, the speed is in the calibrated form. Okay, whatever V value is coming, it is in the calibrated scale, we can find the speed. Normally we are finding the speed in RPM, revolution per minute, RPM. Okay, so here how this voltage will generate means, it will generate because of the relative perpendicular motion between magnetic field and the electrical conductor. So it is because of it voltage will generate. So this voltage, amount of voltage will give the speed of the shaft. This is the main basic principle. First listen the working operation of this so that we can write the basic principle accordingly. Take the description of this TACO generator. In it, this shaft is the input shaft. This speed is to be measured. Okay, machine shaft or engine shaft, input shaft we can call. We have to connect this shaft, okay, to this TACO generator. In TACO generator, main parts are, this is the conductor. So it has winding, electrical winding, and these two are the magnets, okay, north pole and south pole. And here whatever electricity is generating in it, for taking that electricity we are keeping the bushes. Bushes means these are brush type contacts. Okay, just it will touches this, we can call it as commutator, okay, or conductor. So this will take whatever electricity is generating, these bushes are taking that electricity. And whatever voltage has generated, we can see in the voltmeter. We are connecting the voltmeter here. Okay, these are the main parts in the description. Here in the working operation, as I told previously, we had to keep two permanent magnets, north pole and south pole. Because of it, magnetic field will generate. Because of the magnets, magnetic field will generate like this. So these are the magnetic flux. The direction is from north to south. Okay. So in it magnetic field will generate. What we are doing is we are keeping one conductor. Conductor means it is the electrical winding object. So conductor means it can pass the electricity through it. Okay. Electrical wires, winding wires we are keeping here, like cylindrical shape. Okay. We can call it as conductor or commutator. So here we are in the magnetic field, we are keeping this one in it, and here we are keeping the bushes on it. These are the brushes touching the conductor. For finding the speed, we have to connect this input shaft of the vehicle whose speed is to be measured. We have to keep near this shaft, it should be contact with this conductor. Okay, so this, it is, let us assume it is moving clockwise. We have to find this speed in RPM. So it is also moving in the clockwise with the same speed. So this conductor is rotating with this input shaft speed. Okay, already here magnetic field is there. Magnetic field is in the vertical direction. So whenever magnetic field is striking the rotating conductor, okay, so this rotating conductor is 90 degrees to this magnetic field. So in the rotating conductor, electrical energy is generated. Okay, it is the main basic principle in it. So once again I will tell, whenever the magnetic field is striking the rotating conductor, electricity is generated in it. Okay, this electricity is passing in this circuit, and whatever electricity is coming, we can see by using the voltmeter. Okay, this voltmeter or voltage, magnitude of this voltage will tell the speed of this engine or any machine object shaft, rotating shaft. Okay, V is proportional to the speed of the shaft. It is giving in the calibrated form, this voltage value is given, the velocity in terms of RPM. This is the main working operation of this DC TACO generator. Here, just now I told voltage is proportional to the speed. So here we are getting the speed in terms of RPM, okay, in the calibrated scale. If you are connecting to the two wheeler, okay, but it is showing the speed in terms of kilometer per hour. Okay, kilometer per hour. So here again we have to take the calibrated scale. It is giving the value instead of RPM, kilometer per hour. So we can see that value in the indicator. So like that we can use this voltage, magnitude of this voltage in terms of kilometer per hour in the automobile vehicles. Applications of this TACO generator is we can use in the automobile vehicles and two wheelers, four wheelers and also rotating machine objects, and we can find the speed in terms of RPM or in kilometer per hour. And also we can use this as voltmeter for the generators. We can find how much voltage has produced. So as voltmeter also we can use this DC TACO generator. And then advantages of this tachometer is output voltage is linearly proportional to the input speed. So it is easy to find the velocity of the vehicle or velocity of the rotating machine object. And then it has the less maintenance and the cost is also less compared to the mechanical tachometers. And then what are the limitations of this? Means in it, the electricity is passing, we have to use the insulator whenever we are using, so for avoiding the shocking.